Gracious God, send us your spirit now. We might hear your voice through the words of this artist. Know what you might say to us this day. We pray in your son's name, amen. Lean on Me is a quintessential American song that is popular for many reasons. One, the chords are just delicious, making it a favorite for every a cappella group ever, and every college student that thinks they have the ability to find harmonies while singing along with their friends. I mean, who hasn't spent hours just trying to find harmonies to go along with that melody? Okay, maybe it's just me, but could be. It's also a song we as Americans love to sing. It's fun. I saw heads bobbing just now. And it reminds us of the best of ourselves, of the society we wish to be. Whether or not Lean on Me actually captures how we live as a society is maybe more of an open question, but it's who we want to be. We want to be that place where neighbors can turn to neighbor and know that things are okay. For these and other reasons, Lean on Me is an extremely popular and well-known song. And this morning I want to assert that it is also a great song for what it means to be the Church of Jesus Christ. Over the next 2 months, we will look at several songs and ask what they have to say for us about how we walk as Christians and how we walk with Jesus. But this morning, the song that I have brought talks to me less about the specifics of that walk and more about what it means simply to be the Church. For me, the answer to the question of what it means to be the Church is as obvious, and what the song says to us about it is as obvious as it is hard to live up to. To be the Church is to care for one another, to be a place we can go for mutual caring and support and strengthening, to connect with one another and journey with one another on this thing we call faith. It is to be a community together in the name of Christ. That's what it means to be the Church. Being Christian, by the way, is a different set of criteria, and the Church in many ways is meant to empower us in that part of walk. So when I say this is what it means to be the Church, I'm not ignoring the love your neighbor, love God stuff. That's actually a higher priority. But the Church is about empowering that love. Paul, in his book to the book of Galatians, gives a similar theory to what it means to be the Church. Bear one another's burdens, Paul says, and thus fulfill the law of Christ. And again he writes, let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap at the harvest time if we do not give up. So then, if we have an opportunity, let us work together for the good of all, and especially for those of the family of faith. For Paul, the support given to one another was part and partial of what it meant to be the Church. The community that was created by this was, if not the whole deal, then a rather large and important part of it. Paul calls that building of the community, that supporting of one another, fulfill the law of Christ. By doing so, you fulfill the law of Christ, Paul says. So we know that he took this building of community very seriously. It wasn't the heart of the gospel, that would be the grace in Jesus Christ. And it wasn't necessarily the first things Christians do in their walk of faith, but it does seem to Paul to be what the Church was called to do and be. In other of Paul's writings, he shows the same thing. In the letter to the church at Corinth, Paul lambasts them for their divisions, even around communion, around the Eucharist, and encourages them to find a unity in the community, even using the image of the body of Christ with many different members, all playing a role, all necessary, all work together. In 1 Thessalonians, he calls upon the church to encourage one another with words of hope. Words of hope in the face of death and confusion about the second coming of Christ. Encourage one another, Paul says, because that's who you are meant to be as the church. The church for Paul was about mutual care and support. And if it wasn't functioning well along these lines, well, then it wasn't functioning well at all. Now, Paul is writing to a minority culture, theologically and culturally, to a group of people who are also culturally minorities, and many of whom were on the lowest rung of society's ladder to begin with. And so it shouldn't be a surprise that Paul sees the church as a way to care for one another, because if you don't, who's going to? And, so, and we also ought to be wary, therefore, of grabbing too quickly to all of what Paul has to say, since we now live in a society where Christians are no longer the cultural minority. Not when most people in this country, at least the majority, would claim the name Christian and asked whether or not they live up to it. And where our collective social power in this room is eons above that of Paul's first audience. And so to wit, Paul has some exclusivist claims buried in this text. The idea that caring for the community of faith is more important than anything else, we ought to be cautious with that. And not let it be a claim that says we shouldn't care for those outside of our walls. We clearly should. Also, while I say that Paul sees building of the community as partial and foremost to what it means to be the church, we can't let that be all we do as a church, and we typically don't. But with those caveats aside, it's clear that for Paul, the church and the community it's found therein is meant to be part of what we do as Christians gather together for mutual care and support. All of which brings me back to our song for today. Lean on Me is nothing if not a song about community. Lean on Me when you're not strong. Lean on Me when you need a helping hand. Lean on Me when you need what I can give you. And be sure that I will ask the same from you when the time comes. I mean, your mileage may vary, but that sounds to me like the church pretty good. That's the church right there. That is Paul's vision of a community that helps to carry each other's burdens, of a community that is there to support one another at all times, a community that empowers the ministry and would lead the very life of its members. Community, within the song, not just where goods are shared or words offered, it's full service. If you need me to be there, call me. I'll help carry stuff. If you need my help, call me. I'll be there. If you need some faith to borrow, that was an interesting text I discovered reading the psalm. If there is faith I have, you need to borrow, call me. After all, if you need me to be there, help you believe in yourself. If you need someone to help be your cheerleader when you go through a rough time, well, then swallow your pride. If you have faith, if I have faith, you need to borrow. Because I can't fill those spiritual needs without knowing that you need them filled. But when I do, I'll come running and do what I can. That's powerful stuff, friends. That's the church. It's no wonder that this song has become such a part of our American psyche. Now we only keep holding on to it. Because I can't talk about building up support and caring for each other without naming the elephant in the room, and that's this. We as Americans especially are very bad about actually asking for help. We have this image in our minds of the American dream of pulling ourselves up by the bootstraps, of rugged individualism, not of collective support and action and care. We have this image in our minds of doing it by ourselves. And we can forget the image of the gospel and of this song, that we're not meant to do it all by ourselves, but meant to call on help when we need it. I forgot this once. It was my first summer after my first year in seminary, when I was in my apartment. It was hot, and the air conditioner I had in the window was a borrowed one. A friend of mine had gone home for the summer, and she borrowed to borrow her air conditioning unit so it wouldn't be hot all summer long, and I had finally bought my own. I wanted to return hers back to her. And I thought, I can do this. Why not? It's not that hard to get a window unit. I can pull it out. And so I tried to pull the air conditioning out of my window. It was hard work. I lift the window with one hand and grab with the other. And guess what? I see you laughing already. I finally got the window up, and as I went to grab the unit, plop. I was on the first floor, thankfully. But the first floor of this particular apartment was still half a story up. So it worked. Sort of. Not the best, but it wasn't non-working after the least. My friend got my new air conditioning unit that I just bought at the store, and the one that only sort of semi-worked was my unit for the next year, because it just didn't seem fair to break her air conditioning unit and give it back to her broken. I forgot to ask for help when it was clearly needed. I didn't forget again. I tell you this, not just we can laugh at the pastor, although I do believe that occasionally embarrassing stories with the pastor can be helpful, because it stands out in my mind as an example how clinging too hard to individualism and not asking for help can harm us and hurt us. And I'm hardly alone. How many of you have heard or said, well, I didn't want to be a bother. I didn't want to make someone go out of their way for me. I didn't want to be a burden. Often we heard someone say, well, I didn't want to ride, or I don't need to take it to the store. I don't want to be a burden. We forget. We forget that those of us who are called to help others in their times of need need the second half of the song. The one that says, there will be a time when I need you to lean on. We forget to allow ourselves to be served by the same community that we have served. To allow ourselves to receive the help that we so often have helped, gotten, and given. That we are to carry one another's burdens, and that means an occasion that we are the ones whose burdens need carrying. Forget. We don't have to. We can remember this anthem. We can remember the work of the church. We can live as people who are there for each other and allow ourselves to be helped when need be. We can live this vision. We just can. Unlike some of the projects we're given as the church, this one is doable. In each and every day, we strive to be there for each other. I remember lean upon each other when we need it. So go and do so. So go and lean on me, and on me, when you're not strong. And I promise I'll be there to help you carry on. And rest assured, my friends, it won't be too long till I, too, will need someone to lean on. Let us sing about being there for each other, singing hymn 530.